funniest comedians, and he holds Australia very close to his heart. Time to meet our next special guest.
If you hopped inside Ross Noble's head, chances are you'd see things in a completely different light.
If you think you're being patriotic wearing them, but of course when you put them on, it covers up the Australia. So only you know.
He's even got his own show.
Tweet me and tell me what there is not enough of on TV and I will put it in the show.
Sometimes it works.
Surprised my wife at Newcastle Airport. Plane arrives from Malaga at 2:30. Oh!
Yes!
Yeah! And sometimes things don't quite pan out so well.
How dare you!
But he's back here in Australia and ready to make us laugh and cry. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, hey, it's Ross Noble.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi there.
Hello.
Studio 10.
It's lovely to be here. I love the way that the audience gave me a standing ovation. It's a beautiful thing. And also respect to the man who went, when those doors open, give him a standing ovation. I don't even think you didn't even show those people standing up.
No.
So they stood up for no reason at all. Fantastic.
Now, Ross, you're back in Australia.
I am, yes, as far as I'm aware.
To be honest,
I'm not sure. This is a hologram. I'm still a bit jet-lagged, so, yeah, I'll take your word for it.
All right.
If you say I'm in Australia, but at the moment I kind of feel like I'm sort of here and, yeah.
What do you love about this wonderful country?
What is there not to love? Mm. I mean, what I do...
Your wife, for a start, I think. You're married to an Australian, aren't you?
Yeah, I am, yes.
Wow, you are jet-lagged.
That was
you're
a
like,
bit...
wife? Where's what, wife?
No, but that just had a weird vibe of, like... Do you love your wife? We just need to establish that. What I noticed though, which is quite when I was getting, because I am wearing makeup. I know it's hard to believe, but I just felt so sorry for your poor makeup lady who basically. Well, because you're all very healthy people who see sunlight, and that poor woman was literally sat down and she went, okay, and she just looked at my pasty face and it was just like started applying it and I thought this could go a bit canny if we're not careful, you know. But she just kept applying it and then just kept trying to make me look normal.
They're magicians.
So you look very normal.
I do now, but I look like I'd come out of a crypt before. Because it's that thing if you land and everyone's just healthy and lovely and looking good. And then, you know, you just look like you've come out of the shadows. And that poor woman, she was pulling out stuff that she'd never used before, you know. Creosote she's put on me. Yeah. It's quite nice.
Freewheeling is the name of your show.
It is, yes.
Tell us something about it.
Well, basically, it's a TV show, but it's a completely unplanned show. So what we do is I've got a motorbike and a film crew, and then I use Twitter and I just say to people, what are you doing? What's happening? What do you want to see on telly? And then people just... footage you can see here is somebody said, I want to see pensioners arm wrestling. So, they said, I said, what do you want to see? So I just found these two ladies and said, would you like to arm wrestle? And you don't see it on telly, do you? And they really went for it as well. Like this, he's loving it. Look at that fella there.
Did they get a prize?
No, they got to be on. This fella here, somebody said they wanted to see somebody. Oh, thank God they cut away from that clip because that you can't show that at this time.
What happened?
Exactly. What happened there? That was somebody wanted to see. How shall I put this politely?
Yes.
They wanted to see somebody. Put themselves in harm's way involving a crab.
Okay.
A nipping crab. And when I say put themselves in harm's way,
they were nude?
Their undercarriage. They wanted to see a man put himself in harm's way. It was very tasteful. He was wearing...
I
want to know what was tasteful. For the crab, something was tasteful?
This is the thing. Oh, no. It was...
Because Joe... We might actually get Joe to do that. Some good ideas.
Every time someone mentions something like that on the show, Ross, I end up doing it. So please, leave the crab. I've already had crabs down there. I don't need another one.
Oh, no! I heard that.
coming.
Oh my gosh, a kilometre away. I heard that.
But that was the mad thing. This is the way that, like, you know, telly works, is the fact that it was not a good day for the crab,
yeah,
as he was looking up, as it was looming down on him.
But the crab's like, you call that a meal?
Oh dear.
The crab, this was the mad thing, right? So the show is literally, it's anything that we wanted to be. And we went, let's do this, let's get. So we tweeted out, we said.
So let's move on from the crab.
Hang on, let me just, I just want to answer his question. Hang on. So basically, they said they weren't worried about the man's undercarriage.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
They were worried about the crab, you know, animal rights, and we had to have a big long list of things. The crab must not be, you know, putting undue stress and all the rest of it. So this poor bloke is there exposing himself to a crab, and the crab is literally
had
just
more
like,
rights than he did.
So what we did was, because you're allowed to do cookery shows with crabs, so I basically got him to wear a pinny, and we wore chef's hats, and then that way we got around the fact that it might be cruel to the crab because we didn't cook it. So it was a cooking show. So that's probably why that restaurant had a bad review.
Yeah.
They went, would you like the crab?
No, thanks.
So it's a show where anything can happen, but it hasn't been bought over here yet. So if there's anyone watching, from Channel 10 that would like to. Look, Jono said, does he run the place now? Jono's just got it. We love it.
I'll give you a check after this.
Lovely.
We'll take it. Channel 11 or Channel 1? What do you reckon? There's a big following.
Why do I get the feeling that it's basically going to be me with some VHSs in Jono's house with him writing a cheque?
It's the same sort of thing. It's still on telly.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, pretty much what happened to the last guest. We haven't seen him since.
Now,
Ross, I don't know if you know this, but I have a segment on the show called What in the Weird that they're constantly trying to axe.
Right, OK.
And now they've tried to do it by having me come on after the comedian. I think... Would you stick around? Would you actually do the segment for me?
Oh!
Yes.
That's good.
Yes.
And also, you can catch the incredible Ross Noble touring right around this wonderful country, beginning later this week, then for a stint at the Melbourne and Sydney International Comedy Festivals. Please thank Ross. He's going to stick around. And all the details are on our website for those. Now, ahead on Studio 10 this morning, why Steve Martin is getting back on stage for the first time in 35 years. But next, it's not your...
No,
what
it's
in the
Ross's,
weird.
Ross's
Ross
Noble's. What in the Weird.
What in the Weird.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Don't worry, neither do I.
It's just what you did.
Because that was weird.
Yeah. Doesn't involve any crabs. And also, coming up, a shocking confession...
Does it involve these bananas? Hey, welcome to It's Comedy Time. See the guest try and make his way across the table. Is that in case the guests aren't funny? You just put them down here. And actually, it's a TV show. You're running a monkey sanctuary.
No.
This is unbelievable.
We're actually not on air. Anyway, stick with us. I don't know what's going to happen next, but we'll have more in a moment.